Hello people of YouTube, my name is Brad, this is my channel Adam Orange, and welcome to part 3 of the Locomotive 260 build. We've already put this one together, but we didn't get to the second car. We've got to put the coal car together, which is what we're going to do in this video. This ended up being kind of a long build, a lot to show. Not a bit fiddly, but not bad. Like, it took time, but I've been through worse. Somebody asked me how it compared to the Y-Wing. Y-Wing is definitely more complicated, but this one is a bit fiddly, as trains are with the things under here. I can't remember the names. I had it written down from my notes earlier, but the pistons and the connecting rods and all that stuff, just it's fiddly to do. This, not as much so. It's a little more straightforward. You still have some wheels to put together, but they're fairly simple, just repetitive, and it's not as seemingly complicated as the locomotive itself. Anyway, let's get back to building. Let's go put this together so we can finish the 260 build. Thank you. I used the length of one of my tweezers along with flat nose pliers for pressure to bend the top edges of part 101. Should have bent it more than I did. I realized that after attaching it, but I wasn't able to cleanly finish the bend at that point. Did the best I could. I did not use the tweezers to fold over the top part of 102. Instead, I used the long nose pliers, and that didn't go so great. I realized the top needed to be folded down more, and I did my best, but as I said previously, it was not easy, as I could not get to it as well now that the parts were attached. So that top edge is a bit wonky. Now we are entering into repetitive parts. I'm going to cut out a lot of the repetition, such as folding parts 105 over and over again. You need to fold 8 altogether, and it is a simple fold. Why show you it over and over? Don't forget to pay attention to how parts are oriented as you put them together. I added parts 106 to all 4 assemblies. I use the rolling block with a small drill bit to help shape part 109. Of course, you need to shape 4 of part 109. If folding down of those sides seems a little out of order, it's because I dropped one of the parts while folding and got them mixed up. I went for a smaller drill bit for a better fit. Part 120 has a little slit along the back that is apparently meant to fit over the folded down flap on the rear. It took a bit to line it up, but it fit nicely. I was at first worried about which set of tabs does part 22 go into. Then I realized there was only one set spaced out properly for them to fit. Thank you. I needed some support on the main part to bend the other parts. And there you go, it's all done and finished. We have our coal car to go with our locomotive. So we have the complete set. So I mentioned in part two, I had to glue this part on and it got a little crooked, so there's no turning it. So this is gonna be a little off. I mean, it's gonna be a display. It's not like it's gonna go on the tracks and move around. It'll work. This is still a bit wobbly. I don't even think I'm gonna mess with it. There's some issues with this. I mentioned in the video, these side rails are wonky. I didn't want it to be like that. They are thin and difficult to fold over. I tried to fold them over before putting the sides on. Didn't fold them enough. So I had to go back and try to fold them more, and it just didn't go well. If you look down them, they're wavy, and the more I tried to fix it, the worse it got, and I just stopped. It's going to be like it is. Maybe at some point with more patience, I'll come back and try to fiddle with it. I do that sometimes after I built the model and made a video. I'll go back and fiddle with it a little more. Maybe, maybe not. But this is all done. This part took 2 hours to build, so it did take a little bit of time, or it took longer than it felt. I mean, it seemed to go quicker, but it ended up taking 2 hours. So the overall, like the locomotive itself, took 3.5 hours. So altogether, this is a 5.5 hour build. And breaking it up like I did, because I did kind of break it up into the three sections as I was building it. I actually, when I put the bottom half of the locomotive together, I stopped the camera, I took a break. Came back later and did the top half. Once I finished the locomotive, I took 2 or 3 day break, or day and a half, something like that, and then came back and started on this. So it didn't feel so bad. And that's definitely something I recommend. Take breaks. Don't do it all in one sitting if it's a long build. It'll make it easier. Unless that's your thing. Whatever. But it's all put together. I'm going to have to put a review video together for it now. So that's coming up next. But we have all three parts of the build video. So if you haven't already figured it out, if you only want to watch how to put the bottom half of the locomotive together, or the top half. You know, those are part one and two, and part three is just the coal car. So I'm going to try and title them that way so that if you're only looking for one piece, you'll get it. But anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you to my Patreon supporters for continuing to support this channel. As always, keep on keeping on.